on ESPN. Welcome one and all to NFL Kickoff Weekend 2004. Hope everybody had a great Labor Day weekend. I'm Chris Berman. Now we're ready for some football. We kick off our coverage of the NFL on ESPN with what ought to be a pretty good one. Arizona, Jacksonville, now!
The fans are finding their way to their seats, those who really own those seats, as we get set to begin this exciting game. Welcome to Alltel Stadium. I'm Dan Stephen. My friend and colleague Peter O'Keefe is beside me. Peter, this game features what could be an intriguing matchup between a talented tight end and a hard-nosed, tough, strong safety.
No kidding, Dan. It may not be on the casual fan's radar, but I'm interested to see who comes out on top here.
Freddie Jones is a talented and imposing receiver. This guy's ripped. All that muscle helps him break a tackle or two when he needs to.
Hold on, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a real dogfight in store for us.
Well, all right, Peter. We'll keep our eye on him as the game progresses. But first, the coin toss.
Tails of it.
Number 10, kicking off for the Jaguars.
There's the signal, and we're
it's
ready.
Time for Jaguar football.
Scobie kicks it off to begin the game. Scobie fields it all the way back at the 8. Jukes brought down at the 35.
Josh Scobie got a very respectable return off that nice kickoff there, Dan.
The Cardinals will start this drive at their 35-yard line. Goes right up the middle and chews up about 4 on the play.
Don't you see that? Now that's deep. That's deep.
What's the pass? Second and 6. Ball at the Cardinals, 39-yard line.
Chip gets the toss and runs into traffic. Grant makes the hit in the backfield at the 36.
Deion Grant targeted the ball carrier early, didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Nice job eliminating any forward progress on that play. That will bring up a 3rd and long. 3rd down and 4 wideouts in the game. Catches it over the middle, and he will be short of the markers. It'll be 4th down.
Kawaki Thomas tackled him so close to the markers, he can probably taste it, and along with the dirt and the grass he's trying to spit out.
And I'll tell you what, this looks like it wasn't that difficult to tackle, but he had his hands full.
Now, looks can be deceiving, Dan. He really had to square himself perfectly to make that play.
Player takes the long snap and punts it away. Tackled at the 27.
David Allen did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
Jaguars send their offense out on the field and will start this drive at their own 27-yard line. Smith catches the heater left sideline, and that's good for 6.
Byron Leftwich made a nice throw there, got it right past the defender.
They move the ball, and it will be 2nd down. Second down,
second and
4 yards to go.
Ball at the Jaguars, 33-yard line.
Smith goes in motion. Taylor will get the carry on 2nd down and picks up a couple.
Number 35 with the tackle. Third and 2. Ball at the Jaguars, 35-yard line.
to it. Throws into a crowd here, and by some miracle, gets a completion out of it. I don't know how that happened, Dan. Let's have another look.
There you go. Well, the D haven't covered, and they just couldn't get to the ball in time. A perfect pass.
You can't coach that. That kind of pass is instinct.
And, Peter, that play doesn't get off the ground unless he runs a very precise route.
And he had to beat his man. Couple of the best banging heads there.
Brady goes in motion. Leftwich ropes this one to the end zone, and it falls incomplete.
Now, Brady, we've had some room on the outside on that play. If only he had made the catch. Incomplete.
That would have been a touchdown, but instead, after the incompletion, they will face a second down.
Yeah, Dan, you have to take advantage of opportunities like that.
Second down, goal to go. Hill tips it away on the coverage. Incomplete.
Number 21.
Ronaldo Hill got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
That play would have set up a manageable third and short.
But instead, they forced the incompletion. That's how the D is supposed to play.
Third and goal. Ball at the five.
Oh, let's watch this. Five wide out versus a D that is wisely loaded up on DBs.
Leftwich throws a bullet to the flat, and it's intercepted.
Intercepted.
Bang down at the nine. It'll be first and goal.
David Macklin has a monster play for the D. He picks off the ball here and then takes it downfield for a huge gain. Man, you cannot coach that.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Cardinals are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at the 9-yard line. Picks up one on the play.
Marcel Shipp stuck close to his blockers, but the play folded quicker than an over-caffeinated origami artist.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second down with a split backfield. McCown throws a bullet to the flat, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
James Hodgins looked to be in perfect position to make that catch, but it didn't come together somehow.
If complete, that would have made for a bit shorter third down play, but not much.
Not a lot of potential on that call.
Johnson catches it left sideline, and that's not enough. He's short of the markers. That will bring up fourth and goal. Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Rackers from 20 yards, and they take the lead.
That's what I'm talking about, baby. We're bringing it. I'm bringing it. Yeah.
Neil Rackers has little trouble pooching this one through. Let's see it again. Yep, he knows that you aren't allowed to miss many of those in this league.
Neil Rackers kicking off for the Cardinals.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Rackers booms a beauty here. Allen downs this in the end zone for a touchback. The Jaguars were intercepted last time out. We'll see what happens here. We'll start at their own 20-yard line.
Dan, bunch of receivers out there. Defense is expecting that end. Over the nickel.
Taylor takes it for his second carry and gains about 3 yards.
Ronald McKinnon with the tackle. Second and 7. Ball at the Jaguars' 23-yard line.
Luzar handles it in the flat, and that will be a gain of 3 yards.
Complete. Number 21 with the push out of bounds.
Third down, empty backfield.
Ball at the Jaguars' 26-yard line.
Leftwich just rifles this one, and the completion is made. Short of the markers, however. Fourth down coming up.
Adrian Wilson brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
The defense's back was against the wall, and they rose to the challenge, Peter.
Yeah, Dan, that's great D. They had to make a stand here, and they stood together.
It will be fourth down. And that'll do it for quarter number one. The Cardinals, with a small lead, 3-0. Hanson lines up to punt after the three and out. Hanson gets the snap and pummels this one deep. Bolden fields the deep punt at the 22. Tackle at the 31.
Anquan Bolden returned for a few there, but after that gigantic punt, it was like tearing a single page out of War and Peace. It doesn't make much of a dent.
The Cardinals have been locked in a defensive struggle so far. They will start this drive at their 31-yard line. Chip makes his fourth carry of the game and passes the line. Stopped at the 32.
Marcel Chip had blockers on his side on that last play, but the defense was too smart. It gave him nowhere to go.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second down from the shotgun. Bolden goes in motion. Chip picks up about 2, and that brings up third down. Tips it to the left sideline, and it falls incomplete.
Rasheen Mathis is shadowing very closely, close enough that the pass was incomplete.
The defense forces fourth down, and even if they had completed the pass,
it still would have been short.
Yeah.
You have to run those routes farther in that situation.
Player lines up for the punt. Player gets the ball and punts it away. Fields to punt at the 25.
Return of 5.
Tackled
the
at the 31.
David Allen didn't have much room to work with back there. The special team squad made sure he couldn't respond to that really nice punt.
The Jaguars have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive as they start at the 31-yard line. Leftwich puts his arm into this one, and it's caught at the 47, punted down at the 46. It will be first down.
Jimmy Smith tutors his man on the finer points of coverage on this play.
A nice catch, but also a nice move to shake the coverage.
He owned that matchup.
A beautiful pickup, Peter. Everyone on the offense is happy about that play.
Definitely. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
And it will be a first down. Hill launches this one way out right and rambles for about 5.
Adrian Wilson with the tackle. Second and 5. Ball at the 41.
Bring Leftwich rifles it out left side, and he's on target for a gain of 5.
Byron Leftwich had no trouble zinging that one past the secondary. That was one heck of a throw.
A decent play, and they'll now face third and short.
That's the key, Dan. Make third down easy, and they did just that.
Now they just need to convert. We'll see what they do. Third down and less than a yard. Taylor bulldozes right of center and hurdles his way to a first down.
Fred Taylor played it smart back there by following his blockers, and that allowed him to make some good yards.
A nice play, and with only a short distance to the first, they put it together and make it happen.
Yeah, third and short always looks easy, but it's not, Dan. That's good execution.
Smith goes in motion. Holmes in on the tackle back at the 36.
Dexter Jackson was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
That's his second tackle so far. Second down from the on. One man to beat. And he's in for the touchdown.
I'm coming out.
Adrian Wilson picks off the ball, and he's going all the way. Nobody can stop him. Man, I hope his mom's got the VCR going.
The touchdown was his for the taking, Peter. Good individual effort.
Yeah, and great teamwork, too.
Neil Rackers to attempt the extra point. Scott Player holding.
Here's the extra point.
The extra point is good.
It's good. There's the signal, and we're ready. Rackers kicks this one away. Allen fields the kickoff at the one. Dodges a tackle, run down at the 26.
David Allen received that nice kick and a nice little run back after the catch. Good job.
Jaguars offense has to score here. This drive will start at their own 26-yard line. Leftwich fires this one over the middle, and it's intercepted. Dragged down at the 28.
Raynard Thompson shows why you think twice before throwing a pass in his neighborhood. Watch. Great presence of mind to try for the football there.
That's their third interception of the game. And, Peter, the D is homing in on the passing game.
Yeah, tough play. I love it.
The Cardinals come out on the field, and they're looking to extend their lead before halftime. They'll start at the 28-yard line. Bolden goes in motion. Intercepted. Tackle at the 14.
And this is a nice interception. Check his position out to make the grab.
Got it. Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Jaguars have turned the ball over the past two times out. They need to hold on to it as they start this drive at their own 14-yard line. Taylor gets the handoff and picks up a couple.
Fred Taylor used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
And I'll tell you, Peter, he made a great tackle there. He brought down one of the more elusive backs in the game.
Well, you're absolutely right, Dan. But if there's one guy on this defense that can stick with the ball and make the play, it was him.
16-yard line.
Second down, tight end to the left. Will get stopped at the line, and that will bring up third down.
Fred Taylor used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Leftwich throws a heater right sideline, and this one is incomplete.
With the deflection.
All day, baby.
Hanson lines up deep in his own territory to punt it away.
Number 81 to make the return.
Hanson takes the snap and punts it away. Mulder takes it at the 39. Stopped at the 44.
And Quan Bolden got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there. And by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Cardinals come out on offense and are well ahead. They have yet another shot to score and start this drive at their 44-yard line. McCown zings it to the right side and it's tipped.
Pass is incomplete.
Incomplete.
Mike Peterson with the deflection.
Josh McCown is really struggling out there today. As you can see by the numbers, it's all bad. Up to now, he's got 14 yards and one interception.
Second down,
second
two wideouts on the field.
Ball at the Cardinals, 44-yard line.
They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete.
Josh McCown got some big pressure back there, and that affected the throw.
The incompletions keep piling up, and even here in the second quarter, it doesn't seem to be improving.
Not at all. They're just not getting it together. The timing, the routes, the protection, nothing.
McCown gets some air under this pass and this time at the third. The Cardinals take their first timeout.
Don't let them move like that, Jags. Come on, let's play some defense.
First down, three wideouts in the game.
Ball at the 33.
No good. Incomplete.
Incomplete with the deflection.
Okay, Bolden.
Second and 10.
Let's call an electrician.
Ball at the 33.
McCown throws this on a rope. And the Cardinals will take a timeout. That's their second. First down, 10 yards to go. Rackers kicks from 39 yards out, and it's good.
Yeah, all right, that's how we do it.
Scott Player handles this high snap perfectly. Sets up the ball. There's the kick, and it's good. 3 points.
The field goal will extend their lead some here in the first half.
It's still early, but the momentum is definitely behind them now.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Rackers rockets this one deep. Allen decides to take it out of the end zone. Dragged down at the 22. And that'll do it for the first half of this one. The Cardinals enjoying the lead 13-0. And now let's send you to Chris Berman in our studios in Bristol for the ESPN Halftime Report. Boomer?
All right, kids. Interesting game at the half. We'll get back to you guys in a bit. First, we welcome everybody to our ESPN Halftime Report. I'm Chris Berman. Look at our halftime stats here, and boy, look at the difference in passing yards. The Cardinals have a pretty sizable lead, and they got to feel fortunate to have one. We'll pick up the action midway through the first quarter. David Macklin would come up with the big play to kill a drive as he was able to step in front of a wayward pass for an INT. After driving 6 yards on 3 plays, Neil Rackers gets the call as they can't punch it into the end zone, but the short field goal is up and good. Connect on the field goal. The Jags midway through the second. Jags back by 3. Adrian Wilson shows some great awareness here as he gets himself into position to pick this one off. They're now up by 10. The Jags middle of the second. Raynock Thompson shows some great awareness here as he gets himself into position to pick this one off. Jags back 10-0. Deion Grant was in the right place at the right time as his interception was a possible momentum shifter. Cardinals coming up on the end of the half, ball at their own 43. Josh McCown connected with his man on this one. That set up a 40-yard field goal. And that's where we'll leave this one. Jags are down at the half, 13-0. Today's halftime hero has turned in an incredible performance thus far. Adrian Wilson has played outstanding. So that'll do it from here. Let's send you back out now to Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe. Dan?
Thanks, Boomer, and welcome back to our broadcast presented in ESPN Game Sound. Designed and developed in collaboration with Dolby, the leader in surround sound technology. The Jaguars get the ball first this half, and they could use a score right out of the gates to get back into this one. They currently trail 13-0. Let's get down to the field and the action. Tofield downs this in the end zone for a touchback. The Jaguars' offense is now on the field, and except for a few big plays, they really can't be happy with their passing game up to this point. We'll see what they call on this drive as they start at their own 20-yard line. Leftwich fires this one over the middle, and it's tipped incomplete.
Ronald McKinnon got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
The defense stood up to that play and shuts down what would be a minimal gain anyway.
Second and 10.
It'll be second down.
Ball at the Jaguars, 20-yard line.
Brady pushes this one down as well past the markers for a first down.
Al Brady faces double coverage on this play, but still comes out with the ball. Nice throw and nice catch. Let's take a look. They had him covered well, but he was still able to make the catch. As a great receiver.
A lot of short completions like that today, Peter, where they get stops right soon after the catch.
Yeah, if you can't make anything happen after the catch, those short throws are useless.
Leftwich throws a bullet to the flat, and it is not reeled in.
Jimmy Smith
incomplete.
Jimmy Smith went to the outside on that last play. Had some room, but couldn't make the catch. Incomplete.
That's the third incompletion his way, Peter.
Yeah, and he's starting to look a little frustrated down there, too.
Second and 10. Ball at the Jaguars, 36-yard line.
Taylor carries it past scrimmage and gains about 3 yards.
Face mask, number 21, defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Ronaldo Hill clearly tugs on the face mask here. You just can't do that and get away with it. Check it out. Yep, there's the flag. Definite face mask. That's a personal foul.
They're going air. They're going
first
air.
And 10. Ball at the 46-yard line.
Let it bleed.
Leftwich throws a heater, and it's tipped.
Incomplete.
Adrian
Wilson swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
That is their fourth batted ball. Tell you, we've seen a number of good defensive plays from this squad.
We sure have. We'll see if they can keep it up, though.
Second down with the tight end right. Smith goes in motion. Taylor has his number called on second down and heads wide right. Stopped at the 42.
Third and six. Ball at the 42-yard line.
Leftwich fires this one over the middle, and it's tipped.
Incomplete.
That will bring up fourth down.
Dwayne Starks managed to disrupt things. He got in there, and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Hansen gets ready to punt this away.
Number 81 to make the return.
Hansen gets the ball and punts it away. Bolden fair catches it at the 10. The Cardinals have a long field ahead of them and start this drive back at their own 11-yard line. McCown throws a beauty to the right side, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Larry Fitzgerald had three guys covering him, but look what happens. Incredible catch.
First and 10. Ball at the Cardinals' 30-yard line.
Bolden goes in motion. Fitzgerald grabs the bullet, and he's got the first down and a whole lot more.
First and 10. Ball at the 49.
Second down, two tight ends in the game.
Ball at the 46-yard line.
Chip gains 3 yards, and that will bring up third down. Goes in motion. McCown throws a bullet to the flat, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
First down, Cardinals.
Josh McCown has been searching for a rhythm out there, and he's come up short, Dan. As you can see by these numbers, he's been having a rough day of it. So far, he's struggled to get 93 yards and no touchdowns.
Let's go, baby. First and 10. Ball at the 38-yard line.
This pass will fall harmlessly to the ground, and it's incomplete.
Second and 10. ball at the 38-yard line.
Molden goes in motion. Punches this one left to center and gains about 3 yards. They get the first on third and long.
Anquan Boldin does a great job here battling three defenders. It's definitely worth a second look. Let's watch. And he still comes up with the ball. Wow, you can't coach that.
I'm glad he finally nabbed one because he's had a string of missed catches before this.
Yeah, his quarterback obviously didn't lose faith in him though, Dan, because he's kept throwing it his way. Self-ship used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
And that'll do it for the third quarter. The Cardinals enjoying the lead 13 to nothing. Second down, one man back. Jones makes the catch out to the left and is well past the markers for a first down.
Freddie Jones has three guys covering him, but look what happens. Incredible catch.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
Great execution.
First and goal. Ball at the 4-yard line.
Jeff takes his 10th carry of the game and gains about 3 yards.
Second and goal. Ball at the one.
Chip has the call again and maybe picks up one on the play.
Marcel Schiff used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there, but they'll get another shot on third and short.
Look at those tackles. That's how you play sideline to sideline.
Hodgins goes in motion. Rips him down in the backfield, and that moves them even farther away from the goal line. That will bring up fourth and goal.
John Henderson targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
They come up with the big play, and on third and short, they force the fourth down.
Yeah, they even caused the loss of yardage. What a time to come up big.
Scott Player holding.
Rackers from 18 yards and puts it straight through the uprights and good.
Yeah, good job, man. Yeah.
Neil Rackers has little trouble pooching this one through. Let's see it again. Yep, he knows that you aren't allowed to miss many of those in this league.
That field goal makes him 3 for 3 out there. Hasn't missed one yet.
And you can't coach
that. Neil Rackers kicking off for the Cardinals.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Rackers kicks it off. Allen catches it back at the 2. Brought down at the 25. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. Well, the turnover column has the grim news, in my opinion. If you want to win, you have to hold on to the ball.
David Allen was able to find some weak spots in the defense. Got a good run back off that kick.
The Jaguars stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their own 25-yard line. Brady grabs the ball right side and gets past the markers for a first down. Leftwich zips it to the left sideline and it's caught at the 47. Eventually runs out of bounds at the 49. That will bring up first down.
Jimmy Smith must have a cold or something because the defense stayed away from him on this play. He was wide open. Check it out.
You know, you don't see a receiver get that open very often, and they took advantage of it.
Yeah, the quarterback was probably in shock.
Peter, I'm sure he's happy to bring that one in. The last three passes to him have all been incompletion.
He's struggling a bit there, but this may turn him around.
Jackson makes a play on this one and forces the incompletion.
With the deflection.
Dexter Jackson came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
You know, as a team, they are batting down passes left and right. That is their sixth so far.
Wow, great anticipation of the pass.
Second down and four wideouts in the game. Leftwich lives it to the right side and it's complete for a gain of 3 yards.
Adrian Wilson with the tackle.
Taylor catches it in the flat and is at the 40. First down at the 37. It will be first down.
Dexter Jackson gives it his all on this play, Dan, but it is too little too late. They pick up a few yards and a new set of downs. Well, he forced him out of bounds, but not before the marker. He should be more aware of where he is on the field.
That's his second tackle so far. The reception's made at the 36. Second down, and this is the seventh play of the drive. Hill makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Holding, number 27, defense. 5-yard penalty, automatic first down.
David Macklin clearly earned the flag on this one. He held his man a little too obviously here. Yep, defensive holding is the call, and I got to agree with that.
First down, the clock is stopped at 1:57.
28-yard line.
Leftwich throws a heater right sideline, and it's tipped incomplete. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you. Second down and five wide receivers take the field. The Jaguars take their first timeout.
Oh, a lot of weapons out there, Dan. They can get you through the air or on the ground.
Leftwich rifles it out left side, and it's caught for the score.
Touchdown, Jaguars.
Byron Leftwich makes a terrific completion and double coverage here.
Wow. Now that is one confident QB.
Well, it's closer now, but Peter, time is definitely not on their side.
You said it. They needed that score earlier on.
It looks like they're going for two. Wilson grabs the fastball over the middle, and he's in for the two-point conversion.
Well, he's going to carry the ball here, and he does his job by scampering in for two. He's in, and that's what you call a great play.
They're setting up for the onside kick. Scobie bounces it up. Gets it off the bounce at the 39. Ground to a halt at the 37. The Cardinals start this drive in great field position at the 37-yard line. Johnson goes in motion. Smith beat the Jaguars. Will take a timeout. That's their second. Second down. The clock is stopped at 1:40. Smith gets the handoff, and the Jaguars take a timeout. That's their final one. Third down, three wideouts in the game. Smith picks up about two, and the clock will continue to run. Fourth down coming up.
Well, Dan, they didn't get the first, but they did manage to stay in bounds. Looks like they're playing the time game, and they just won another 40 seconds.
Neil Record.
Check it out. That's a confident kicker's stats. No sign of hurry from the offense. They're going to take it slow here, Dan. They're concerned with one thing right now, and that's the clock.
Rackers boots it from 50 yards out, and it's no good. It bounced off the upright and then out.
Neil Rackers doinks the upright here. Let's watch this again.
Well, sure, Dan, it's a little embarrassing, but isn't that what instant replay is all about?
A player screws up, and it's our ratings grabber.
That's his first miss of the game after going 3 for 3.
I don't care how many he makes, that one miss will eat at him.
The Jaguars will start this drive near midfield with the clock at 50. Snags the dart right sideline, and the clock continues to wind down.
With the tackle.
Leftwich unforks this to the left sideline, and they can't connect. Incomplete. Williams had to leave the field earlier in the game, and now Susie Calder has a report. Susie?
Thank you, Dan. The trainers have just informed me that he suffered a bruised hip in that last collision. They're letting him work it out down here, but it doesn't seem to be doing much. They're listing his return as doubtful. He's trying to shake it off down here, but with time running low, he may not be able to return. Back to you, guys.
Thanks, Susie. Third down, empty backfield. Edwards catches it in the flat, and that's just short of the markers. The clock continues to wind down. That will bring up fourth down. Leftwich throws a bullet to the flat, and it falls incomplete. They will turn the ball over on down.
David Macklin with the coverage.
Jermaine Lewis does a quick out here to get open. The ball zings to him.
but it's incomplete.
They had the right idea there, going for it, trying to put the ball in the end zone, but they couldn't convert.
It was the right time to roll the dice, Dan, but this time the house wins and they turn it over. Dan, this game is over. There's no way for the D to stop the clock, and the offense is just going to sit on the ball to win this one.
Tonight's game, the Cardinals come out on top 16-8. For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.
Okay. It's going to be coming to you, baby. It's going to be coming to you.
All day.
All right, gang. Great work as always. And with that, we welcome everybody back to the ESPN studios for our ESPN Video Games post-game show. I'm Chris Berman. The Cardinals stepped it up for sure, putting up some good numbers. Let's get started in this one early in the third quarter. Byron Leftwich would find his target on this one. Josh McCown would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. That set up an extra point-like 19-yard field goal. The Jags trying to answer back. Jags losing by 16. Byron Leftwich would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. And that's where we'll leave this one. Cards edge out a win, 16-8. Now let's take a sec to chat with our player of the game, the guy who seemed to be all over the field on defense and came up with big play after big play. Adrian Wilson is on the field with our Susie Calvert. Suze?
Thank you, Chris. You played great today, and you nosed them out in this nail-biter game. What put you guys over the top?
Well, I have to give it up to the other team. I got to give them credit for playing hard and making us really work for it. We just leave it all on the field and let the chips fall where they may, and luckily we came up with the win today.
Chris, back to you.
Well, that just about does it. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll see you next time here on ESPN celebrating 25 years as the worldwide leader in sports. I'm Chris Berman. So long.